Hey everybody, this is Christopher here with AG Productions. Just wanted to go ahead and get started on our new set of videos. This is going to be the How to Paint Orcs videos. We're going to start out with skin today. I've already gotten most of this orc painted up here. What we're going to do here is we're going to paint the muscles on the back, and I'm just going to show you how to paint the muscles on an orc. Essentially, it works the exact same way as painting everything else. We take each muscle and we use it, we act as though it's an individual piece of the model. And we'll take each particular muscle and highlight from the bottom to the top. So the bottom part of the muscles will be the darkest, and the highest part of the muscles will be the lightest. That's about as easy as it can get. So this particular orc, since he's a smaller orc, this is a, I believe the title of this one is called a Lesser Orc Sergeant. He's I'm painting him in a very light green, more of a yellowish green. If it's a larger orc, such as this one right here from Reaper. This is an Orc Shaman, I think. It's a much much deeper color. Kind of a bluish green is what I painted this guy as. But I generally tend to, the smaller the orc, the more I paint him up as almost like goblins, for sort of a yellowish green color. So this guy right here, I'm using two colors, basically, to get this skin color effect. I'm using medium olive green from Vallejo Paints, which is very similar to Snot Green from Games Workshop. And then I'm using Flat Yellow, which is, I think, either Sunburst or Golden Yellow, one of the two. But my original base color for the model was just this medium olive green. My first highlight, which I actually already have on the back here, was three parts medium olive and one part flat yellow. And the part that I'm going to start on right now, that I've already got mixed up, is two parts medium olive and one part flat yellow. So what I'm going to do is I'm simply going to start right here. I'm going to start with the neck right here and just make a couple lines. This is very simple stuff, very quick painting. All right. And once you get the hang of the flesh color, it becomes very, very fast to do. Now, what you'll notice is there's various cracks and crevices and muscles and things like that, and you don't want to make them all that deep, dark green color, that medium olive green color that we started with. Because let's face it, some of the cracks are deeper than the others, and so if they all look like they're the same depth, your model's going to look really dumb. So you have to kind of pick and choose which of the cracks you think might be deeper than the others, and the ones that are a little bit more shallow, what you'll do is you'll fill those in until you get to an appropriate time where you need to highlight them, or where you need to stop filling them in, and you'll just highlight the muscles around them. Alright, so that's one highlight. Like I said, this is going to go real quick. The next highlight, all I'm going to do is add in one more drop of the flat yellow, and I'm going to make this basically in a one-to-one mixture of flat yellow and the medium olive green. Alright, I'm going to pick up a little bit of that on my brush, just like this. And again, we're going to start, and we're going to work basically on the tops of the muscles. And think anywhere where the sunlight would hit the model. Now, you'll notice I'm not dry brushing this model. Skin is an awful, awful thing to dry brush. I don't care if it's human skin or orc skin, doesn't really matter. You never dry brush skin. Dry brushing should be reserved for very, very textured surfaces, or when you want to create a dusty feeling. Like, for instance, if you're doing claws, that's a good place to do some dry brushing. But never on skin. It makes your model look real sloppy. So, the next highlight that we're going to pick on, I told you this is going fast. We're going to do one medium olive, and I'm sorry, we're going to do one medium olive. Yeah, one medium olive. And two flat yellows. So I tell you what, let me just add another flat yellow to the mix here instead of trying to come up with a whole new color. Let me just do this real quick. There we go. Alright. Just like that. Get a little water in the mix here. Okay. And I know that a lot of you are wondering why I don't just, buy paints that run in progressions. Honestly, the easiest choice is I can control the paint a lot easier. So you can see that we're progressing nicely from one color to the next. That's all we want to do, and it's very difficult to find a paint set that has enough progressions from one color to the next that you actually like. There's very few out there. Foundry's probably the closest one, but for the most part, they only have three progressions that you can run through. And so it's a lot easier to mix your own paints, I gotta tell you. And if you've never mixed your paints before, it's a great time to start doing it. No time like the present, no matter what you're doing. Alright, just like this. And on this muscle, we're just not going to come down as far as we did the last time. Just like that. See? We're highlighting up towards the top. Okay. And I'm going to add one more drop of flat yellow, and this will be my final highlight. Alright, let me get a little bit of water in the brush here. A little water in the mixture. This is mostly yellow at this point. As you can see, this is just like that. See, we're running down this progression just like that. And if you've never seen any of my Let's paints, this is a little bit of what you actually get in the DVDs. It's a little bit slower in the DVDs, so you actually can get a little bit more instruction. But for the sake of YouTube, I'm having to run a little bit faster than normal. Alright, and again, we're just focusing on hitting the areas that are sort of sticking out the most and the areas that are closest to the top of the model. And there we go. That's about it. Let me hit a little bit down here. Just like that. Okay. Now the back of that orc is finished. So he's ready to go. If you're wondering about the hair, I have done the hair. His hair is black. Whenever you do a black, you've got two choices of highlights. You can either highlight in gray, which looks really stupid, or you can highlight in blue, which will actually make the model look like he has black hair. If you highlight with gray, it looks like they have gray hair, but if you highlight with blue, it actually ends up looking black. The tongue I've colored in a very dark red color, and the eyes, I don't know if you can see them or not, but they've been colored in with red, and then they've been dotted where the pupils would be with what's called golden yellow from Vallejo Model Color. It's this color right here. It's basically yellow with some white in it, all right? So that's what we've gotten done so far. Next step I'm going to do is probably the leather, which I've got a little bit of a base coat on right here. And then probably going to move on to the sword. I don't know if I'm going to show the entire sword of how to do the non-metallic metal look, simply because I've already got a video out that shows how to do non-metallic metal, and it's much more in-depth than this. We spend almost 45 minutes on just non-metallic metal, and so I really can't do it justice in 10 minutes worth of time or less to actually try and explain to you how to do the entire sword. So I may skip that and just show you how to do the leather and then the teeth on the model, and then go ahead and finish him up. But he's looking pretty good so far. I know you're wondering about the base. Well, I've only got half of it flocked. excuse me. The reason is, this half over here is going to be dirt. And the half that's not flocked, we're actually going to turn into water. So it looks like he's stepping into a river, maybe chasing after an enemy. And the way I saw it, he has his hand raised up in the air, kind of like he's mad that they're getting away. And he's sort of running into the river after him. I don't know. Just thought it would be kind of a neat little addition to put into the model. So there you go. That's our orc so far right now. If you're interested in this orc, feel free to take a look at ReaperMini.com. That's Reaper's official website. And the title of this particular character is the Lesser Orc Sergeant. And he goes with their Warlord line. I think these things cost about $3. I don't know. Reaper figures you'll actually find are generally much cheaper than Games Workshop figures. So if you're looking to practice, I would definitely recommend Reaper stuff. They're actually, number one, not only are they cheaper, they're actually better quality too. The figures are much more well sculpted, and they're a lot easier to learn how to paint on. So I hope you enjoyed today's lesson on orc flesh. And I will see you guys next time with a lesson on how to do leather. Take it easy. Have a great night. God bless you. I'll see you later.